Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In this video, we'll make a very useful home automation project where you can control 8 home appliances with Bluetooth, Wi-Fi and from the manual switch. If the Wi-Fi is connected with the ESP32, this blue LED will turn on, then you can control these 8 lamps with the Blynk and also from the manual switch. And you can see, you can monitor the real-time status in the Blynk app. Now I will turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without internet. You can see the blue LED automatically turns off, so now I can control it with this Bluetooth app and from the manual switch. So first I have to connect the ESP32 with this app, and you can see it's showing connected, so I can easily control the lamp from these buttons, and I can also turn off all the lamp with this button. Now I will control it from the manual switch, and you can see I can also control it from the manual switch. Let me turn off all the lamps. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. If the Wi-Fi is available, then ESP32 will automatically connect with the Wi-Fi and this blue LED will turn on. Then I can control the lamps with this Blynk app and also from the manual switch. And you can also use push button instead of this manual switch. So I will highly recommend you to watch complete video, and during the video I will share the complete circuit diagram, the code for this project and all other details. So let's get started. To make this home automation project, you need ESP32, a 8 channel relay module, and to control the home appliance manually you can use your existing switchboard. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. Now as you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact I have designed a custom design PCB for this project and ordered it from the JLC PCB. You can easily order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload a GABA file of the PCB, then select the parameter like quantity, masking color, then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will receive the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try out JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. These are the components required to make the circuit on the PCB, and after soldering all the components, the PCB will be look like this. Now I will connect the ESP32 with the PCB. Before uploading the code, I have to quickly configure the Blynk app for this project. So you can download it from Google Play Store or App Store. Now I will tap on open, then tap on new project. Give a project name, say ESP32 automation, then select the ESP32 dev board. Connection type should be Wi-Fi, then tap on create. Now Blynk will send an authentication token to your registered mail ID, which will be required in the code. Now again I will tap on OK. Now I have to add 8 button to control 8 relays from the Blynk app. Now I will tap on the first button. In the pin, I will select virtual pin V1. Then to turn off the relay, I have to send 1, and to turn on the relay, I have to send 0, as I am using active low relay module. Mode will be switch. Thus, I have created our first button. In similar way, you have to configure next 7 button with virtual pin V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7 and V8. To control the 8 channel relay module with Blynk. Thus you have to configure all the 8 buttons in the Blynk app. Now we can move to the coding part of this project. This is the code for this project. You can download the code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article and you can download the code from this download button. Now before uploading the code, you have to download and install the ESP32 board and after that you have to install all these three libraries. I have already explained this in my previous video. I will share the link in the description and also in the I button. After installing all the libraries, you have to enter your Wi-Fi credential. Here you have to enter the authentication token sent by the Blynk. So I will go to the registered mail ID and copy the authentication token and paste it here. Here you have to enter the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. If you refer the same circuit, then after doing this much of changes, you can directly upload the code to ESP32 board. For that, go to Tools, select the Do It ESP32 Dev Kit V1 board and the proper port, then hit the upload button. When you see this type of connecting text, just press the boot button and you can see the code started uploading again. I have connected this 8 lamp with the relay module as per the circuit, and I will use this mobile charger to give 5 volt to ESP32. Now let me turn on the supply. Now I will quickly install the Bluetooth switch app which I will use for this project. You can download it from the video description. Then you can go to file manager APK, and this is the app Bluetooth switch v1.apk. I will tap here and tap on install. As I have not submitted this app to Google Play Store, so this notification will come. I will tap install anyway, then tap on open. So this is the Bluetooth switch app. We will control the relay module with this app after some time. As you can see, the blue LED turns on, which indicates the Node MCU is connected with the Wi-Fi. So I can control it with the Blynk app. Let me show you. You can see I can easily turn the lamp on and off with the Blynk app. Now let me control it from the manual switch, and you can see the real-time status of each switch in the Blynk app. So let me turn off all the switch. Now I will turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, the blue LED automatically turns off, so I can control it with the manual switch and from the Bluetooth app. Let me connect the ESP32 with the Bluetooth. For that, I have to turn on the Bluetooth and pair the ESP32 first. And I will tap on ESP32_BT and pair it. After pairing the ESP32, I will go to the Bluetooth switch app which you have just installed and tap on tap to connect. Then select ESP32_BT and it's showing connected, so I can control this lamp with this app. So let me turn on all the lamp. All lamp turns on. Let me turn off all the lamp. All lamp turns off. I can also control the lamp individually with these buttons. Let me turn off the lamps. Now let me control it from the manual switch. You can see I can also control the lamp from the manual switch if there is no internet. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. You can see the blue LED automatically turns on, which indicates now I can control it with the Blynk app. Let me show you, and also from the push button. So this is a very useful project you can make for your home. And if you like this home automation project, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.